Before we do, let me, there are some great leading politicians in New South Wales who've taken themselves away from their busy schedule today to be able to address us. And I'd like first to invite Guy Zangari, the member for Fairfield, who's a strong supporter, to join us and share with us his words.
Thank you. Thank you, Brendan. Good afternoon, everybody, to all the reverends, to Archbishop, Bishop Umbers. It's great to see you all. Can I just say, firstly, as a parliamentarian, to stand here in front of you today is bittersweet. And I think you know why. The bitter side of it is that we are here united against a bill that is a kill bill. And as the Archbishop has rightly put it many, many times, it is just that. And I know that the Reverend Fred Nile is here with me from the upper house, and Kevin Connolly, a good colleague, member for Bankstown, who is the chair of the Parliamentary Friends of Religious Freedom, was supposed to speak and unfortunately could not come down because of Parliament sitting. So she sends her apologies. But one thing I will say to you, the sweet for us is that we are all here together fighting this. Yes, it is a very difficult topic, but it is one that can be solved with better outcomes in health, better outcomes in palliative care. Are we kidding ourselves when we spend billions of dollars to sustain life in a space station and yet we can't do the same to put that towards keeping people alive on Earth? I mean, are we serious? Who are we kidding? So tomorrow, God willing, when I'm in the chamber, I'll be voting against this bill. Just like I did with the so-called reproductive bill, the abortion bill. I voted against it. And I will stand here every day of the week with all you good folk here, praying for me and with me, along with my colleague, Kevin Connolly, fighting the good fight. Because we are going down a very, very slippery slope. Very slippery slope. When then, as parliamentarians and as governments, we then shirk our responsibility to preserve life, to keep people alive. And as the Bishop said, Archbishop Fisher said, the two-tiered system, you got the A grade and the B grade. How unfortunate is it then that maybe because of your postcode, because of your credit card, or maybe your inability to pay for private healthcare, the answer for you is a simple vaccination to end your life. We have spent thousands, millions of dollars in our community over the last few months telling people, go get vaccinated. Why? Because we want to keep you alive. Because the coronavirus is real. And then at the same time, under the same breath, whilst we were locked up in Fairfield particularly, a bill arrived about voluntary assisted dying. Let's get our priorities right here. Let's get our priorities right. Let's realise that life is sacred. While ever there is life, there is hope. So friends, I, along with Kevin and our colleagues tomorrow, and who else is here? Who else do we have? Oh, here we go, Nathaniel Smith, member for Wallandilly, and Reverend Fred, and many others will be in the chamber fighting the good fight. All is not lost. We are going to fight this till the very end because we believe in life. We're choosing life above everything else because that's what the plan was for us here on this earth by Almighty God. Thank you all, and I look forward to keep fighting for you in the Parliament.